time of 3 minutes 44.39. Morsley unbeaten in his last 29 races over 1500 metres or a mile. His last defeat in those events stretches way back 3 years. Well, Steve Ouellette, as a great miler yourself, I'm sure you admire the skills of this man. We'll come back to Morsley in a moment. Let's have a look at the other 13 athletes in the field. We have the American Mark Daly, who will set the pace. Morsley, El Gharouj, second in the World Championships and the World Indoor Champion. El Bassir of Morocco, a fourth in Gothenburg. Holman of the United States, Kemai of Kenya, Sullivan of Canada, Suleiman of Qatar, Dubus, the Frenchman, Chekamani of France, Shabunin of Russia, Great Britain's John Mayock, and Marcus O'Sullivan of Ireland, who also helped to set the pace. But going back to the main man, Morsley, Steve, he has been saying for the last couple of years, really, that he wants to hold every world record, I think from 800 metres up to about 10,000 metres. It would seem an impossible dream. Can he achieve it?
I don't think he will, no, to be absolutely honest. I don't think he's got the capability of breaking the eight. And I think that there's a few Kenyans that might, and actually a few Ethiopians that might deprive him of some of the top echelon levels there of the five and the 10,000 metres. But in his own event, the mile and the 1500 metres, totally dominant. Almost a relaxed performance in the World Championships. And all the time he was saying he was going to come here and crack it and have a good crack at the world mile record. And I think that he's determined enough to do it. He's got the right pacemakers to do it, and I think this will be a very, very fast race indeed.
And certainly whatever happens, the prediction made by his predecessor, Saeed Awita, has come true. Awita said, if I was the man of the 80s in the middle distances, then Morsley will be the man of the 90s, and how true those words were. In his world record race in 1993, Morsley completed the first 440 yards in 54.9. He went through 880 in 152 and reached the bell in 248. So the mile distance, which sadly was removed from the calendar in the big Oslo meeting this year, the Golden Mile, is back in the limelight again here in Zurich. And it's back probably in the hands of one of the greatest exponents of the distance. The American Mark Daly leading them through this first lap, and Morsley, who always looks so easy, seemingly, whatever the pace, just drops into third place behind Ireland's Marcus O'Sullivan, who'll take it on when Daly tires.
But he's in the perfect position at the moment, is to stay on the inside as much as he can, just follow the pace. I think the other athletes are quite respectful of the fact that this is a world record attempt, and they're not trying to push and shove anybody. And at this rhythm, you really can't. You can't afford to be extravagant and waste tactical disadvantage.
Look out for number 56 there in the blue shorts. That's William Kemai, who was the last man to beat Morsley over a mile, and in doing so set his own best ever mark for the distance, 3:48.8.
Well, it's a nice wide-angle shot, really, but it doesn't really show the pace at the front. All you can really see is that the group is really spreading way, way out there. I don't think we're going to see much change in the rhythm. Mark Daly's taking them through very strongly. O'Sullivan, there he is, just tucked in behind. Marcus, a great miler in his own right, knows the pace you have to go through on the third lap. El Gharouj is there in fourth of Morocco,
wearing number 55 in the blue shorts. Let's have a look at the time now when they reach the, well, they're giving 800 metres here, so that's not particularly illuminating.
Well, 1:52.4 at 880 yards, Alan.
So that's bang on then for world record pace. Remember, Morsley's time, 3:44.39.
The good thing that's actually happening at the moment is Marcus O'Sullivan is doing a good job there on the third lap. It's the third lap, really, in any race, especially mile and 1500 metres, obviously, or the third part of any race, I should say, that where the record has to be broken. And Marcus is pushing it on. He's tiring now, and Morsley has decided to take it on.
So he's back in a familiar position, racing against the clock. The opposition seemingly beaten, but maybe not this time.
El Garouge is moving up. This is the youngster. But I think the master out front either knows that the pace is too slow for record and just wants to win, or El Garouge behind is having the race of his life.
Maybe they dropped on that lap just a shade behind world record pace.
250.3, three-quarter mile.
Can he do it, Steve?
It's going to be a tough haul now. He's dropped about 3 or 4 seconds. El Garouge, I think, was the barometer for the record. He moved up, and you saw that when he did that, that Morsley really didn't go away. And I think now Morsley's got an awful lot to do on this last lap.
El Garouge, the 20-year-old world indoor champion and world silver medalist, can't keep pace now with Morsley. He stretches away. His target, his own world record for the mile. I keep insisting on showing the metric records and distances here. There's the 1500 metres time as Morsley goes for it again in the home straight here. 3:44.39, the world record for the mile. He's outside it, but it's yet another brilliant run and yet another fantastic time for this quite incredible Algerian.